changes to the payments landscape have seen banks need to adapt to multiple payment methods, from the introduction of digital wallets to the newly released central bank digital currencies. And in this climate, there has also been the arrival of systems such as banking as a service. In this chapter, Gavin Maclean, head of payment products at Lloyds Bank, talks about how banks are making the most of developments like machine learning and big data to take their operations to the next level. The payments landscape has undergone a rapid change in recent years. How are banks keeping pace with this and innovations like central bank digital currencies?
Payments is affected by significant winds of change. And I think there are three main ones. Firstly, progressive regulation, creating the environment for things like open banking to happen. Second is improvements in technology, for example, cloud computing and APIs, enabling new customer journeys that just couldn't have existed 10 years ago. And thirdly is the constantly rising bar of customer expectations. You know, particularly consumers are opting for more digital, more speed, more self-service. And these three winds are what lead to the payments landscape transforming really rapidly. You asked how do banks keep pace. Well, first of all, you know, you need a culture of innovation. You have to be relentless about leveraging regulatory and market changes, using them as a foundation to build innovation upon. I think it's also helpful to view changes through the lens of a customer journey and being on the lookout for things that can enhance that customer journey. You have to leverage your friends. It's a horrible phrase, but you do need to talk to your friends, your third parties, partners, consultants, and really listen to anybody who's got interesting things to say about technology and innovation. And then on things like digital currencies, you know, I think engaging with the industry and being open to new possibilities is a really good approach. And actually, you know, a good example of embracing new technology was when we recently combined cloud computing technology with APIs to allow our corporate and institutional customers to access the UK's confirmation of payee service. And what was really interesting about that is that we developed that solution in a few weeks, a fraction of the time that it would have taken using old tech. But it's also equally important not to get blinded by the glare of what's brand new. You know, we need to remember the value of some of the things that we've already got and find a way to blend some of these new innovations with the tried and tested propositions. And again, a good example of finding that blend was when we used the long-standing SWIFT and faster payments systems and blended that with APIs and with SWIFT's GPI service to create GPI Instant. And that's now enabling payments to come into the UK, settle near instantly over the faster payments system, and to have the payment status updated in the GPI tracker for the sender to see. So yes, it's important to keep pace, that you embrace the new and harness the power of new tech, but it's also important to remember the value of some of the really good things we've already got.
Banking as a service has become a big talking point recently. How are banks utilising these capabilities?
This is a big subject area and really exciting to see how different organisations are approaching it. You've got some relatively new players whose sole purpose is to be the platform that other banks operate on. And then there's actually the much larger group of incumbents who have long operated banking services for their own customers and are now starting to see the opportunity to serve others. And of course, the big strength that that group of organisations have is their own experience of doing this, usually over, you know, many years or decades or centuries in some cases. At Lloyds, we're approaching it in a couple of ways. First, we are enabling our own architecture to take our own services to where clients are. So this includes building API endpoints to enable services to connect up to our clients and third-party platforms and marketplaces and things like that. Good examples of those would be for example, our confirmation of payee API or our trade and open banking APIs. And then secondly, we are looking to enable these services for third-party consumption. So enabling a number of banking-related microservices to be embedded in other journeys. So this might be payment services, data services, risk management, and so on. So we are very much in the camp of having built up experience, systems, people capabilities ourselves for our own banking business, and we're now selectively making some of those available where we think our capabilities could work for others. But I stress that point about experience. Our approach will always be to make available as a service type offerings where we've got deep and relevant experience, not just to rent out our platform to anyone who comes along and asks.
And how are developments like big data and machine learning feeding into the latest banking platforms?
With impressive pace is the short answer. So big data, machine learning, robotics, natural language processing, that combination, that suite of technologies are really key to delivering the real-time and personalised journeys that we aspire to. So we're working in-house and with partners to make best use of the large amount of data that we have. Again, leveraging advances in technology like cloud computing to help us do so. And this will allow us to build models and patterns that will ultimately lead to more personalised and better customer propositions. The pandemic here in the UK required a big response from everyone. And these technologies played a big part in allowing banks to create and scale processes quickly to support customers. And these things, like many of the technologies that we've discussed today that have been shaping the payments landscape for the past few years, these new technologies, they also have an important role to play. So our job is to understand them and then, as I mentioned earlier, blend them into our products and services in a way that improves journeys for clients.